That is right, Java Minecraft players that want to download mods using Fabric for Xaelith Launcher on their Android device. Today, I'm going to show you how to do that. So yes, today I'm going to show you how to set up and download Fabric mods using Xaelith Launcher on your Android phone. Now, if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button. I'm desperate. I want some subscribers, and I just want my own little posse of people that want to enjoy Java Minecraft on their Android. So yes, hit that subscribe button and make sure you check out the playlist that teaches you everything you need to know, including how to install Java Minecraft. In my last video, I taught you guys an advanced guide to set up an internal folder for your Java Minecraft as well, so make sure you check out that video instead of using this default path. And that means that we have access to this folder right here. Now, click on return, make sure you check that off, and click this download button on the top right hand side, and this is going to present you with all the mods, okay? Now, the thing about this is that we can select our mod version, so 1.21.9, we can select it if we want it from CurseForge or ModRinth or CurseForge again, and it'll show you everything that is available for 1.21.9 from both platforms. Now, these platforms are basically hosts for data, so make sure you go support them if you can, because they're hosting a whole bunch of data for free, and it's people like you that helps them continue doing this, because databases are cheap. They're not cheap, okay? Now, you can sort by relevance, top downloaded, your biomes, and click the search by icon, and basically it'll show you your mods for those kind of, you know, categories. Now, for ModRinth, you can do the same thing, total downloads, click all, click search, and it'll show you everything for your category filters. Now, I noticed that it doesn't have all the filters that you can find on the PC, like Cursed, for example. I'm not sure why, but, you know, it's just what it is for now. Maybe they'll update this later on. Now, mod loader, we can select Fabric. It'll show everything that's available for Fabric only. But we haven't installed Fabric yet, so that's very easy to do. Click return. Now, click on the little icon above where it says launch game, and it shows your version. And click on install new version. Click on the version that is the latest one as of today. And then click on Fabric. Click on the latest version of Fabric. Click the Fabric API. Click the latest version of the Fabric API. And now you can name this whatever you want. Now you can name this My Modded World if you want to. My Modded Fabricland, okay? Fabricland, don't sue me. That's a company in Canada, I think. Now click done and click this button right here and it'll install everything that we need. Now wait for it to finish installing. It's going to bring you to this page right here, and then click on that version again and make sure you select the Fabric loader. Now click return, click the settings icon right beside here, click on mod management, and you'll notice that this is our mods folder for hosting all of our mods that we're going to download in a few seconds. The very first mod we're going to download, click on the home icon, is going to be the mod menu. So how do we do that? Don't forget, we click on the version, so click on the version, click search, now click on our platform, which is going to be ModRinth for the most part, for Fabric mods. The reason why is because Fabric mods, or the most part, are hosted in ModRinth, okay? And that's probably because CurseForge is for Forge, mostly. But yeah, both have Forge and ModRinth and Fabric and everything, so don't even worry about it. Just basically search for the mod, and if you don't see it on CurseForge, then search for it on ModRinth. But again, on the most part, we're gonna use ModRinth for Fabric. So scroll down, and we're gonna click on Mod Menu. Now make sure you select the right version. So as you can see here, there's quilt, there's Fabric, quilt, Fabric and quilt, but make sure you select the one that says Fabric. It'll usually be green. Now click on the latest version, and then you're going to make sure you pay attention to this right here. This says the text placeholder API is required for this to work. So click on that. Now click on the latest version and download that mod. Now go back. As you can see on the right hand side, there's an icon for the mod that we're currently in. Click return, and now you can click the mod menu and click on download mod menu and click confirm. Another mod that actually requires something else is the ore harvester mod. So I'm going to go ore and search. So there's the ore harvester mod. I'm going to click on it, click on the latest version, click on this, and it says right here, hey, you have to have the collective mod installed for this to work. So click on collective, Click on 1.2, 1.9, click on that version, click confirm, click return, return. As you can see, we're still in here. And now we're back to the actual page for the ore harvester mod. So click on that, click on download ore harvester, click return. Now, the reason why I wanted to show you that is because a lot of people think that just downloading the one mod is going to fix everything and make everything work. I see it so many times that people are like, oh, I broke something, or oh, I didn't do something right, or got an error, and that's because they forgot to download the dependency or the API or whatever the case may be. And they also forgot to watch my very first video, which told you that you need to have the mobile glues renderer installed. So go watch that now. I'm not going to answer that question if you ask, oh, why is it not working? Well, it's probably because you didn't install the mobile glues renderer. Now click on launch game. Now we logged into our Microsoft account that owns the game. I'm going to click on this mouse icon, drag this little settings icon down here. And now, as you can see on the bottom left-hand side, we are using Fabric, and there's the mod menu button right there. We can click on that, and there's our mods. Now, obviously, you can mess around with this the way you want. Now, click on that GUI button to hide the GUI for a minute, and you can mess around with whatever settings you want. So, ore harvester without sneak. Yeah, I want that, because I don't want a sneak to have to break an ore. And drop ores at first broken block. Sure, I guess so. Or no, or it'll just drop the ores all over the place. So click done, and that's all dependent on you. Actually, I'm going to make it so that I sneak, because you don't want to be digging down by mistake and then dig into an ore and then it just explode everywhere. Your mod menu, you can change things in here. You can show your libraries counted or not. I'm going to go not counted for libraries, because why do I need to see that? Now it'll just show me that I have 3 mods installed, and that's pretty much true because I only have 3 mods right here, right? And then we're going to click done, click on single player, and you're going to click on create new world. Now, what if you had a world already saved inside of your regular Minecraft? Well, that's where your internal storage aspects comes into play. So let's go save and quit. Go quit game. And now we can navigate into MU files, for example, and go down to our folder called Java MC. If you don't have this folder, that means you didn't listen to the very intro of the video where I said you need to go watch that video that teaches you how to set up this folder. Okay, now that that's out of the way, we're gonna click on .minecraft. If you don't see .minecraft, click on this and click on show hidden files, okay? Now we're gonna go down to versions. We're gonna go down to our modded version that we just created, and you're gonna go to saves. You're gonna delete that save file that we just created. Now you're going to go back again, go to 1.2, 1.9, go to saves, click on new world, highlight it, copy it, and we're going to copy it into that saves folder in our Java MC, our .minecraft, inside of our versions, our modded, our, that's our my modded fabric land, by the way, saves, and copy it right there. And the reason why is because maybe you wanted to mod your world after you've been playing on it because you wanted some mods inside that world. Click launch game, and that's very possible, but you can't go backwards. So what I mean by that is, say you had a modded world with these 3 mods attached to it, you can't copy it to a vanilla Minecraft world. That makes sense to most people, then great. If it doesn't, then Google it. Now I basically told you what it means. So click on single player, and there's my world from my very first intro video where I taught you how to set up Xaleth Launcher, and we are in the acacia biome again with all of the ugly acacia wood. If you like the acacia wood, I'm sorry. And there's our cow from the very beginning of the video as well. But now we have these mods, and it's really freaking awesome. As you can see here, ore harvester. I'm not going to show you ore harvester working. Just trust me, it works. Click on quit game and enjoy playing Minecraft Java Edition with fabric mods in 2025. If you like this video, like it. If you didn't like it again, and don't dislike it, because liking it means that you liked it.